What's going on, YouTube? Doc is Sloth. We're back again doing some Rocket League. We actually have some exciting update news to talk about. So we're going to be hanging out playing this. Oh, getting blown up playing this ranked game. And chat about what's coming out here. And actually, the 10th. So, what, 2 days?
Wednesday, yes. Wednesday, May 10th. It sounded like about 6 p.m. for you folks on the East Coast. We are getting a new crate, and it is going to be the Nitro crate. They are wanting to continue this pattern of bringing in crate-specific cars, like the Endo was in the Turbos, and there's been some flack about it. I'm honestly okay with it, because I can actually get those cars for free now. I do not have to spend the $2.99 or whatever it was to get them. I can just play the game, get crates, and if I don't want to open up the crates, I can get stuff for free, which is honestly probably what's going to happen on this next crate here. I did not particularly like, at least in the standing still image, nothing from the crate really excited me, and I'm terrible at shooting. So I think I'm just going to play the game. I'm going to earn those crates, and I'm just going to try and use those crates to get decals and boosts and stuff that I actually want, but we'll see how it goes when we actually see the stuff in action. I'll give it a fair shake, but it looks like we have 2 boosts and 4 wheels coming. There was also talk of some black market customization stuff as well. We'll see if those are the same black markets or if they are new. I would actually like to see some new black markets out. Maybe 20XX will go down in price at some point.
Yeah.
I'm really interested to see. They're bringing in the car is called the Mantis, and apparently it has the same hitbox as the Batmobile, but it's actually customizable. So if you're unaware,
oh, no.
The folks with the Batmobile, you have to use the same wheels, the same boost, no decals, nothing. Nothing about the Batmobile is customizable. So the Mantis is supposed to have the same hitbox, but be fully customizable, and it looks pretty neat. So we'll see how much it kind of affects the usage of the Batmobile, for one, but then also how high it goes in price, especially if there are painted versions of it. I think folks are going to really like the opportunity to use that flat hitbox in a way that they can still customize stuff. So we'll see how all that goes, but the other big thing they're bringing out for this update is Neo Tokyo is back. It's actually a standard map this time. It's not going to be the crazy, stupid ledges that always made me really angry. It's actually going to be a standard map, but with the same, artwork, we should say, outside of the map. Kind of like Aquadome has all the fishies and the shark and stuff floating around. Not Aquadome. Neo Tokyo will still have its real metropolis kind of setting outside. So that'll be really cool, because that part was always really neat about that map. It was just those dang ledges that really made me sad. So they're bringing it back. They are actually going to be leaving in the... they're calling it Neo Tokyo Underpass, with the ledges and stuff. They're actually going to be leaving that in for private matches and stuff, and it's probably going to be a Rocket Labs map at some point.
Yeah.
Which is what it should be. It's what it always really was, if we're honest. It was a Rocket Labs map. I'm going to drop that back for you really poorly. But that's the big things we have for this update. I'm going to be really excited to see what the actual wheels and stuff are. We'll see. It looks like one, maybe two of them weren't really looking like they were going to be animated. But been wrong before, not very often, but you know, we'll kind of let them come out before we fully judge them. But let us know what you guys think of the wheels and the boosts and stuff in the description. We will leave you a link. Pardon me, I am struggling with the words today. We'll leave you a link in there and tell us what you think of them. See if you're going to open up the crates or if you're going to kind of do what I'm going to do and use them as trade fodder to get stuff you actually want, things like that, because I would not mind me a Saffron Tachyon, maybe a little Heatwave, maybe a little Slipstream, We'll see. So let us know what you guys are gonna are you what you're gonna do with the nitros, or if you're actually gonna open them or not.
Yeah, I also know or think that, you know, we're obviously not seeing everything that's gonna be in this too. So, I think you know, I'm sure there'll be some decals and some other things that end up being a part of it that we don't see.
Yeah, the last couple of crates have actually had like painted rare and very rares in there, which is pretty cool. So that that definitely could be an option too. So hopefully with all this stuff, we'll pull maybe another painted endo, so Doc doesn't rub his cobalt one in my face. So, but let us know what you guys think of the new DLC coming out, and anything you'd like to see us do in the future, just throw it down below. We appreciate you watching. Feel free to like, comment, subscribe, do all that stuff if you so choose. We are Doc and Sloth from The Average Gamer Guys, and we will see you next time.
Laters.